Well, thank you, Jay, for that beautiful preview of Fever. That's going to be opening June 27th, so everybody be sure to check that one out. I'm super excited to bring the family and go see what that has to offer. Just let's dive right in. Tell us a little bit about what made you pick this building design and the final project of your storied career.
Well, thanks, Luke. It's been a pleasure to finally unveil it in front of all of you. And though it will be my last official project anyway, as I retire to go off and be old and fat and tend to the garden with my wife, it is also one of the first, you see. I was living in Venice, study abroad sort of thing, in my undergrad, one of the last years before the island sank, and I designed a pavilion that I called Pavone. Probably didn't pronounce that quite right, but it's supposed to be the Italian word for peacock. And it was a social space, a nightclub type thing, but temporary. And the idea grew from that, and it became the first version of Fever for my architecture thesis. And then I went and redid a bunch of things, submitted it again for my final project at RCA. And I got a bunch of colleagues, people I looked up to, creatively designed bits for it. Yusuf Elmana did a couple of drink carts. Gigi Gregory designed a rug that I went and had made. Mary Roy Williams helped with the color palette. She's really a master of color. And Nino Chambers did one of the chairs. So everyone chipped in. It's been one of my favorite pieces to work on and inspired by so many of my favorite places and films, like The Barbican, Selfridges, Coco, over in Camden, Blade Runner, which is probably rather obvious, and many others.
Yeah, that's incredible. I love how you used your resources in your network. So that's awesome. So I can see that you also brought your daughter here with you today. And you mentioned earlier that she had something to do with this project. So how did she inspire your project anyway?
Yes, everybody say hello to Zion. She's over there in the front row. Yeah, so when the space first became available, we were given a lot of flexibility with what we had to do to it. It's a beautiful, a bit demure British Art Deco building over on Wardour Street down in Soho. And it's one of those foot traffic streets in London. And I wanted to give my daughter something that I wanted myself growing up in my early 20s in London. And I actually used to just work right down the street from this spot in a little grilled cheese shop called Pickle and Toast. I think they went out of business like 2 weeks after I left. But when the weekend came around, my friends and I would always just go shopping. I felt like there wasn't much else to do at the time in London. We all had these horridly tiny flats, so you couldn't really hang out at home with more than one or two other people, and any public space required paying for something, besides parks, of course, but you know how London weather can be. So the first thing that I wanted to do is to provide a social space that people could hang out at free of charge. And secondly, when I was younger, London wasn't so 24/7 the way it is now. New York City was, of course, back then, but it wasn't here yet, so it wasn't possible to have a 24/7 building like this. But with urbanization and population density on the rise over the past decades, this has of course changed. And so, well, this isn't so rare anymore. It was important for me to give Zion a place that she could be any time of day if she wanted.
That's incredible. I'm sure Zion can't help but think about you as she's walking through the streets to see how you've impacted just the culture of that region, interactive space. So that's incredible. I'm sure she's very proud of you. Tell me about courting chairs. I hear they're what started this whole thought process.
Yes, absolutely. I think we have a picture of one here that can pull that up. But courting chairs are an artifact of the sons and daughters of 18th century nobility wanting to get to know each other while their parents didn't want them fraternizing too much, if you know what I mean. Sometimes these chairs even came with room for a third person, a chaperone, to keep them in check. The idea came to me, though, that it just might be the best way to get people to interact solely through the use of furniture. I think of myself as a pretty friendly guy, but I probably wouldn't sit immediately next to or across from somebody I didn't know unless I had to. But in this situation where you're sort of next to them and sort of back to back, you can comfortably slide into each other's personal bubble of space. And who knows, you just might make a friend.
Well, thank you so much. I'd love to hear thoughts and ideas and how they all came together to create these beautiful interactive experience for people. So Jay St. Clair, everybody, give it up for this man. And don't forget, Fever is opening June 27th. But that's all for today, folks, and have a great night.